In this video, I'm going to show you 5 ways to fix the Mac OS X black screen of death without having to open your computer or even send it off to Apple for repair. Now, the black screen is not all that common, thankfully, but it can occur after you drop your computer on the floor or knock it abruptly. It could even happen during or just after an OS X or software update of any kind. So if this is the first time you've seen the black screen of death, don't panic just yet. There's a good chance that we're going to be able to fix this problem just by following the steps outlined in this video. Before I show you some of the secret keys, let's just check the obvious things first. Step one is to make sure that you do have power connected to your Mac. It hasn't accidentally fallen out. You've got it turned on at the mains and your battery is actually charged. I know it's an obvious one, but we need to check that first. Second, we need to check the brightness of the display. There is a slim chance that you've accidentally tapped on the lower brightness key to reduce the brightness of the screen down to black. So tap on the right side of the brightness key, the second one along on top of the keys there, and see if that will bring the screen up. Most likely, your problem isn't going to be this easy. So if that's the case and you haven't been able to restore the Mac, let's now move ahead to step two, which is restarting the Mac. Now, some of you have had troubles restarting by using the power button, and that can often be that you need to do a hard reset by holding down the power button for at least 3 to 5 seconds and then releasing it, waiting 15 seconds before powering on again and see if that's going to help restart your Mac. If you find it to be unresponsive, use the keyboard shortcut Control plus Eject keys to bring up the dialog box, then try restart. Still didn't work. Let's move on to the next step. Step three, which is resetting the NVRAM or PRAM. Immediately after pressing the power button, hold down Command, Option, P and R keys together. Hold these until you hear another startup chime, then release them. Your Mac should boot normally now, although you may have lost some settings along the way, so make sure to check your system preferences to see if the display, date, time, and disk options are still in order. If that didn't work, we can try step four, which is to reset the system management controller. And this is a good thing to know anyway, as it can resolve other issues that you might be experiencing with your MacBook, such as overheating and slowdowns. Now, to reset the SMC on your MacBook, follow these steps. Shut down the computer, connect to the power source, and with the MacBook powered down, hold down the Shift, Control, Option, and press the power button at the same time for about 10 seconds. Release the keys, restart the computer, and the SMC should now be reset. If you've come this far, I'm guessing the previous steps didn't work. So now we're going to try step number 5, which is to boot into safe mode. You might be experiencing a black screen for several reasons, and one of them might be issues with your startup disk. You can fix this problem by booting your MacBook into safe mode and allowing it to run a check on the disk. To boot into safe mode, follow the preceding steps. Turn off your computer, hold down the Shift key while powering back up, until you see the Apple logo. Let go of the key after the logo appears, and the computer will now start up in safe mode. In order of priority, I would suggest that you try clicking on the disk utility option first, then click on first aid to repair your disk permissions. Restart and see if everything is in working order. If that doesn't fix the problem, boot up in safe mode again, and this time select the first option, Restore from Time Machine. But for this to work, you would have to have set up Time Machine by connecting an external backup drive and configuring it in the system settings. If you didn't do that, then you can try the last option, which is to reinstall Mac OS. Only do this as a last resort, as you may lose some data in the process. If none of these steps worked for you, then there is a chance there is a hardware issue with your computer. And I can only suggest that you take it into your local Apple store or certified Apple reseller to see if a genius or technician can sort it out for you. All the best. Thanks for watching. If you got any value out of this video, consider subscribing to the channel and you'll be notified of up and coming video releases. Any comments, welcome. Drop them in the comments box below. Bye for now.